cooking, cleaning, gardening, and sewing. Is this the new wellness? Hi everyone, welcome back to The Daily Connoisseur. My name is Jennifer, and we're going to talk today about whether or not homemaking is the new wellness. So Rochelle sent me this article, and this is from Elemental, and it says, cooking, cleaning, and sewing are the new wellness. 1950s housewife chores have been rebranded as meditation and self-care by Rina Raphael. So let me read a little bit of this article to you because I found this to be extremely interesting. It starts the article off about how a lot of women are baking bread again. It says, baking is just one of the many ways US women now find refuge in activities once associated with domestic drudgery. It's something they can proudly tackle and satisfyingly complete, in contrast to other modern day pressures, be it working or parenting or, I don't know, keeping their family healthy during a pandemic. Cooking shouldn't be viewed as a chore or another to-do, but more as a way to be more present, spend more time with family and friends, and to be able to complete the task. A slew of new companies and groups are rebranding age-old chores as self-care. Cooking becomes an immersive escape from tech. Gardening products sell working with dirt as personal time out, and sewing as a form of meditation. Cleanfluencers reimagine the art of scrubbing kitchens. Meanwhile, knitting companies, which sell yarn kits, have grown exponentially by glorifying the benefits of flexing your fingers. What do these activities have in common? To start with, they center around the home. It says, household hobbies allow you to exert mindful effort. Consider them the antithesis to a society that has all its needs met without much exertion at all. In this modern age, we've lost the ability to be bored, and then be inspired, and then create something new. I think home hobbies are incredibly therapeutic. So let's chat about this, because homemaking is one of my favorite subjects to talk about. I wrote a book called At Home with Madame Chic several years ago, and it's really an ode to the homemaker and an ode to life at home. Now, I am an introverted homebody. I am happiest at home. I would never leave home if I didn't have to. And especially with the pandemic going around and so many people having to stay home, this is a very relevant topic. So I think that many women have struggled with household chores in the past. Of course, men, I'm sure, do as well. And I do believe that a strong force behind that is how we view them. How we view our homemaking tasks is so critical to our enjoyment of them. So I think that this whole rebranding homemaking as self-care and wellness is actually quite genius, because it's really about focusing on the positive aspects of the home life. And instead of looking at all of these things as drudgery and daily chores that you have to get over as quickly as you can so that you can then relax and entertain yourself, which is what so many of us want to do, we can actually look at the chores themselves as deeply satisfying. Now, I truly believe that hard work is deeply satisfying, and that doesn't have to be rocket science or solving some great issue. It could be as simple as scrubbing a pot or scrubbing down your kitchen or folding laundry or dusting or ironing. These homemaking tasks that we have to do all the time, we have to do them all the time. They are the mundane efforts that we do every single day. So we might as well enjoy them, right? We have to do them every day. So it's truly imperative that we reframe the way that we think about them. So I love that article on how homemaking is essentially the new wellness. And that's something that I strive to achieve on my channel as well. Ladies, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I would love for you to comment down below, is homemaking the new wellness? Have you always thought about it that way? How do you take care of your home? Where do you struggle? What do you love about it? Let's improve our lives at home. We have to live here, we have to do the chores, and so we might as well enjoy it. In the meantime, I encourage you to keep calm and remain classy, and I will see you next time on The Daily Connoisseur. Bye, everyone. Here's your fork.